when it comes to our life in Christ, it's all about faith. If we're going to be used in the gifts of the Spirit, it comes down to faith. If we're going to see signs and wonders happen, it all begins with faith. If we're going to meet God in prayer, it comes with faith. Faith knowing that when we go to prayer, that God's going to meet us. Faith that when we ask God, that He's going to answer us. We have faith that when we come to church, that God's going to move, that He's going to work in life. We believe that and have confidence that He's going to speak and give us something special for us. When we read His God's Word, we read with an anticipation, in faith, in confidence, knowing that He's going to speak to our heart. Faith is in every area of our Christian life. And it is confidence, it's not doubting. Why don't we just get ready and head here for the week, and then we'll pick up next week and begin talking about prayer. But before we go, I was reading online on Facebook, there's a group I belong with. I can't remember the guy's name. I think it's Jaeger. But he talks about signs and miracles happening and following him. And his life he talks about a little bit. And he throws Smith Wigglesworth in there from time to time as well. But I read yesterday where he posted where years ago his son's finger got stuck between two wedges of steel when they were working. And it was bad. It was really, really bad. His son wouldn't even show him his finger. It was that bad. And he was holding on to it, and he told his son, just give me the finger. So his son placed his finger in his hand, and the guy wrote that he pulled on it and said, in the name of Jesus, be healed and go back to normal, something to that effect. I can't remember the exact words. And he said, his mind didn't speak it. His spirit spoke it. And he said that he could rebuke the pain and commanded it to be gone and several other things. And like that, the pain disappeared. He said he didn't look too at it. He said he just went back to his truck, told his son to go back to work. As he was walking away, his son called him back and said, Dad, look at this. He said, I don't have any more pain, but you could take that finger and he could bend it all the way back to his wrist. He said he never saw anything like it. He could move it any which way he wanted, but he never had any pain. It was rubbery. It could move this way, move that way, bend here, bend there. He said, but by the end of the day, it was back to normal. He could no longer bend it all the way back. He said throughout the whole day, his son didn't have any pain. What is that? That is faith in God, knowing that He can do miracles. Faith in believing, having confidence that what He said, His word is true. And with that being said, I'll close it here, and we'll bow our heads and prepare our hearts for service. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give You all praise and glory for everything You've done for us and shall continue to do. Lord, we thank You that You're God who reigns on high and that there's none like You. Now, even right now, Lord, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray that You set Your angels in the four corners of the property, above and below, that no attack of the enemy may penetrate. I pray that our hearts and our minds will be in one mindset, one accord, that we may worship You in sincerity and truth, that the Holy Ghost may move as He so desires, making Himself visible if He so chooses. I pray right now, Lord, that You anoint the song leaders and the musicians. Give them a special blessing as they praise You upon the string instruments and the vocal cords, Lord. I pray, Lord, that You anoint the pastor's mind and his lips to bring forth the words You have us to hear, Lord, that You give him a special blessing as well. Anoint our minds and our hearts to receive the message which You have for us today. May they be good soil for Your word to fall on, that we would remember it throughout the week, but even greater than that, that we would apply it to our lives, that we may be even more transformed to Your very image, Lord. I pray, Lord, that our faith would grow, that we would not doubt in any way, Lord, that what You say we take it as truth and are confident in it, Lord, that we may see signs and wonders happening and following us wherever we go, not because of who we are, but because of who You are. Lord, we need to see a great revival in these last days, Lord. May we be instruments in that revival. May we be used as You see fit, Lord. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.